And we're now joined by Francesca Acquap of Regina Capital Development Corporation. Good afternoon, Francesca, and welcome to the program.
Good afternoon. Thank you for inviting me.
The Philippines is among the worst performers in Asia today after Australia. Mining and oil, the only index to end in the green. What do you think might be the reasons behind the negative sentiment, and what's your outlook for the PSEI in the near term?
So yesterday's rally didn't materialize today as the PSEI fell by 0.5%. I think what affected the market sentiment today was the revision of the third quarter GDP from 7.1% to 6.9%. Also, investors are anticipating the U.S. federal meetings regarding the tightening monetary conditions. Right now, we're seeing a consolidation range with the support at 7200 level while resistance at 7350.
All right. Well, has the outlook for the fourth quarter GDP already been priced in, especially since the GDP for the fourth quarter will be out tomorrow? What's your house call?
Right. So the fourth quarter GDP will be released tomorrow morning. Our house call is a year-on-year growth of 7.2%. It would imply 5.6% year-on-year growth for the whole 2021. Since during the period, we experienced stronger pickups in economic activity. For example, the PMI in December, it inched up to a nine-month high. It was driven by increased orders because of domestic demand, and also production volumes also grew slightly during the period. So this would indicate improving conditions for the manufacturing sector.
All right, the rally of Vista Malls up to 30% intraday, and the decline of ABS-CBN and ABSP share prices despite its disclosure. Are these knee-jerk reactions, or do you think these completely change the prospects for each stock?
So following the news of Villar's media broadcasting company taking over ABS-CBN's frequencies, Vista Malls was one of the top gainers today. And I think it was just a knee-jerk reaction. The investors were impacted. It impacted the investors' decision-making.
Does this affect the fundamentals of each stock or each company?
For now, we don't really see it. We're waiting for the company's operations, but for now, people will still be watching it, watching the ads.
All right. Well, also a strong and sustained rally from Figaro today, days after its IPO, and Solar Philippines Mavesi has already doubled its value from its IPO price less than a month ago. What prospects are investors buying into?
Right. So both of the recently listed companies have been received well by the market. In fact, Figaro is the top gainers today. For Figaro, they completed their IPO on Monday. They offered it at a discount, its maximum offer price. So I think also it's also because of the PSE's mandate to support local small investors. And to add, it's I think what also affected the sentiment for the recently IPOs was the declining COVID cases, particularly in the NCR plus areas.
But the valuation of right now of Figaro, as well as the other stocks, Spinek, are they fairly valued at this point, at this price point?
For Figaro, I think it's currently fairly valued at its IPO price at 75 cents.
And Spinek?
For SPNEC, I think it's also fairly valued. Yeah.
All right.
Although, yeah, they don't have operations yet when they went public.
Okay, Francesca Acop of Regina Capital Development Corporation, thank you so much for the market guidance. We look forward to our next interview.
Thank you.